Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'm doing another makeup tutorial and I wanted to play around with some colors because you guys know I love my neutrals, but I wanted to incorporate some colors into this look and I've really been into like greens and olives recently, so I wanted to do like an olive green smoky eye type of thing. So this is what I came up with. I really like how it turned out. I think it's really pretty because I incorporated color, but it's still not like boom, super crazy that you couldn't like wear it out to the food store if you wanted to. So yeah, if you guys are interested in seeing how I got this look, then just give this video a thumbs up and keep on watching. For foundation today, I'm gonna go in with a throwback. I'm gonna use the Tarte Amazonian Clay Full Coverage Foundation. And then I'm just buffing that out with a beauty blender. It has been so long since I've used this foundation. I don't know why, because I do really like it. Very nice foundation. I like the coverage that it gives. And I'm using a brand new beauty blender and I'm giving anxiety because it's so pretty and it was so clean and now it's gonna be so dirty. Then I'm gonna go in with the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Concealer to highlight. And then to set that concealer, I'm gonna go into this Wet n Wild contouring palette and use the highlight shade to set. All right, now for the eyes, I'm first gonna go in with Makeup Geek's Creme Brulee. And I'm just using a Mojo Beauty E5 brush to put this into the crease and upper crease area as a neutral blending color. And then to warm up the crease, I'm going to go in with Coco Bear from Makeup Geek. I'm just working that into the crease area as well, and I have this on a small tapered F4, also from Mojo. And then just to deepen the crease up a little bit more, I'm just going to go in with the tiniest bit of Makeup Geek's Bada Bing. And I'm just going to work that into the crease as well. Makeup Geek shadows are so pigmented, so you have to be so careful when you use them to only take the tiniest bit or you're gonna like totally overdo it. Then all over the lid, I'm gonna go in with Makeup Geek's Havoc. Is really cool because it is one of their duochrome shades, so like in some lights it looks green and then in other lights it looks kind of like brown, so it's really cool because it kind of makes the look versatile. And then in the center of the lid, I'm going to pack on Makeup Geek's Ritzy. And then in the inner corner, I'm gonna go in with Makeup Geek's shadow in the color Charmed. This is one of their foiled shadows. It's gonna be super sparkly. Then for the lower lash line, I'm first going to line with this gold liquid pencil from Crown. And then I'm gonna go over that with Makeup Geek's Typhoon. Then I'm gonna go ahead and do my winged liner. I'm gonna be using the NYC liquid liner. For lashes, I'm going to go in with the Icon Lashes in the style Beverly Hills. Now to bronze up the skin, I'm going to go in with this Rimmel Natural Bronzer. I want the skin to look really bronzy, so I'm going to go in with this just to make us look glowing. Then I'm going to contour with Benefit's Hoola. And then I'm going to pop on some of Too Faced Love Blush Blush in I Will Always Love You. For highlight, I'm going in with Becca's Champagne Pop. That glow though. Love Champagne Pop. Then for liner, I'm going to line them with the IT Cosmetics Lip Liner in Buff Nude. And then I'm going to go in with Ofra's Liquid Lipstick in the color Sao Paulo. And then last but not least, I'm just going to go on with the Lipland Cosmetics Lip Gloss in the color It's French. So this is the completed look. I hope you guys did enjoy this tutorial. If you did, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and click the subscribe button down below if you have not already. And I will see you guys very soon in my next video. Thank you for watching.